Kevin wasn't lying. It's going to be massive.
And this isn't even the full mast length yet.
That's amazing. I've seen the crane here for the first time this morning. It's extremely impressive. I'm really proud of what the team has achieved. All the hard work they've put into it. It's so large, it's bigger than I've ever imagined.
We have built a lot of specialized equipment, all the stuff that's not on the market, we built for ourselves. And that's, as an engineer, that is the best thing you can have. An adventure and a quest at the same time.
There is a market demand for more capacity, lifting capacity. We see that coming from offshore wind. We see that coming for multiple markets. And we provide it with the SK6000.
The SK6000 is specifically designed to lift heavier equipment at a larger height and at larger outreach.
It's the first land-based crane providing this load moment capacity. Lifting capacity is huge. When you see the drawings, there's no sense of scale. When you draw a person next to it, you think, oh my god, that's huge.
Just to put one of the engineering challenges into perspective, the sheer load that has to be transferred through this pivot is enormous. We can lift 6,000 tons at the front, where we have 4,000 tons at the back as ballast, and 3,000 tons as own weight of the crane. Altogether putting over 12,000 tons of load just on this pivot.
The big benefit of developing it in-house is that we can combine all the expertise within Mammoet. So operationally, we operate it in the field. We know what we want. Maintenance, we've got the entire history of Mammoet to make sure that we utilize our lessons learned and build the best crane there is. Can't wait for the next steps. Do you know what the next video will be about? We made sure the crane is future-proof by providing all interfaces in such a way that we could connect it to whatever power source we're going to use in the future. When there's nothing available at the client side, we could use generators. But in the future, and also now already, we could use battery-powered from fuel cells or normal batteries. You could use grid power. A lot of options there. We are ready for it.
It makes me very proud to work on such a project. And not just for myself, but for the entire team. When you look into the details and how many challenges you have to overcome and just make a next step in engineering and in fabrication, can we get this done, guys? And then as a team working hard to really get that realized, that is something that makes me extremely proud and proud of the entire team.
So as you can see, the assembly of the SK6000 is well underway.
And in the next video, we'll show you more on the assembly of such a big crane.
So leave your comments below and don't forget to like and subscribe.
See you in next video.